the Academy's quick reference resource for all things spiritually sound and the advancement of accurate knowledge of truth. Today, we will be taking a brief look at entanglements, snares, traps, and pits. The protection of godly wisdom, divine protection, turns out when we are walking in the way and exercising godly fear by keeping God's commands and being wise people, we're much more capable of avoiding things that Paul talks about as easily entangling us. Hebrews 12, verses 1 and 2 says, "Let us also put off every weight and the sin that easily entangles us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, as we look intently at the chief agent and perfecter of our faith, Jesus." When we are walking in the commands of God, we are spared costly mistakes, aren't we? Things that can get us all twisted up and entangled with stuff that is of no spiritual benefit, or does it work towards building up our relationship with God in Christ? Let's first look at entanglements. Entanglements are distractions from the way, and they hinder us from following the course that best serves us and glorifies God. Many times entanglements present themselves in the form of distractions. And distractions come in very various forms themselves, don't they? Proverbs 4:25 gives us preventative measures that we can take to avoid distraction that entangle. Here we're counseled, "Let your eyes look directly ahead and let your gaze be fixed straight in front of you." When we are focused on the things presented us in Christ in our walk with God, we're not looking around at all the distractions and the stimuli of the world, which includes the counsels and the empty philosophies or faddish beliefs, nor are our heads turned by every wind of teaching or inspired expressions not originating with God. Excuse me. And we can follow the admonition at Isaiah 41:10, where God tells us, "Do not gaze about." Many times, actions begin with a thought, and thoughts often enter first through our eyes. Recall Eve in the Garden of Eden, and how she was looking upon the fruit and saw that it was good to eat. Our focus in life and our gaze should be right in front of us, in the way, the path of righteousness. Looking about can cause us to deviate from the way and get all entangled in stuff. When we deviate from the way, the roadmap of life, that is the counsels found in God's word, we are put in harm's way, and we can easily fall victim to snares, traps, and pits that are intentionally placed and cleverly disguised. Because if you clearly see a snare which takes up foothold and instantly you find yourself dangling upside down and control of your own destiny is lost at that time, if you would have seen that cleverly disguised snare, surely you would not have stepped into it. Or what about a trap? Traps tend to come from temptations. Notice that traps are generally set with some sort of attractant or enticement. I give you a mousetrap, for example. When setting a mousetrap, the trapper sets some sort of enticement, like a piece of cheese or peanut butter in the trap. And this is like entrapments in our life. Usually one enters a trap through temptation, enticement, or some sort of an attractant. Peter talks about traps of enticement at 2 Peter 2:19. "Although they are promising them freedom, they themselves are slaves to corruption." Showing godly fear by sticking to God's commands serves as a deterrent to entering temptations and finding ourselves trapped. And how about pits? Pits are also cleverly disguised, usually camouflaged, blending into the environment, and an unaware person does not know that they are stepping into a pit until the trap door opens beneath your feet and gravity provides its share as you abruptly hit bottom, and with a thud, you find yourself in a deep pit of darkness with walls too high to scale. This is one reason Jesus commands us at Matthew 10:16. Look, I'm sending you forth as sheep among wolves. Therefore, be cautious as serpent and innocent as doves. There's a course of preventative measure that Proverbs chapter 4, verse 18 hints at that helps us avoid entanglements, traps, pits, and snares. Solomon, in his wisdom, said the path of the righteous ones is like the bright light that is getting lighter and lighter. You see, walking the path of righteousness serves as a light to us, revealing these cleverly disguised things so that we can avoid them. Psalms 119, verse 105 tells us, your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. So, walking on our roadmap, God's word, in the way, following Jesus, and paying heed to our compass, our spiritually trained conscience, lights up the path on our way in life and exposes dangers. These things, snares, traps, and pits, are very real dangers and threats when we veer off the path. When we leave off relying on the roadmap that God has provided us, we very likely will encounter these things on the path that is out of the way, the path that leads to destruction that is talked about, Jesus talks about it in Matthew chapter 7, verse 13. He says, going through the narrow gate, because broad and spacious is the road leading off into destruction. Remember the admonition at Proverbs 4:27? Do not turn to the right or to the left. Turn your foot from evil. And Proverbs 2:20, that you may walk in the way of good men, and the paths of the righteous you may keep. See the purpose. We can easily, however, become lost if we do not stick to the roadmap and follow in Jesus' footsteps. Upon these stray paths that lost souls wander on, we become special targets and can face severe predatory attacks. So when God, when he tells us not to do something or to abstain from certain things, it's not because he's a control freak or a puppet master, but because he wants us to fare well in life and to thrive and to be protected, not harmed. Just like any loving parent wants for their child, right? So living a life of godly fear and keeping his commands certainly serves as a protection for us from snares, traps, dungeons, and pits, also entanglements, and also saves us from getting lost along the way and being vulnerable to predatory attack with no shepherd around to rescue us. Another way living a life of godly fear protects and serves us is we're spared from many fears, anxieties, and worries of the world. Having hope in the promises of God serves as an anchor for our souls through the storms and troubled waters of life. Hebrews 6:19 assures us this hope we have is an anchor for the soul. Hope keeps us grounded and sensible in these times of senselessness. When we hold our hope in God close, he holds us close, that we might be, as Ephesians 4:14 depicts, no longer immature like children. We won't be tossed and blown about by every wind of new teaching. We will not be influenced when people try to trick us with lies so clever they sound like the truth. Now, we know that the plans and promises of God are the only assured true things in life, and we store them up in our hearts, and we are eagerly awaiting for the fulfillment of God's purposes and promises. It is in this hope that we find comfort and peace. People in the world that are alienated from God have a lot of fears to what the future holds for them, the human race, planet Earth, and every living thing upon it. But we who know the promises of God and live faithfully to them are rewarded with relief and a measure of comfort from these things that people of the world are preoccupied or overly worried with. This is not to say that faithful people of God will not suffer or be persecuted or imprisoned or put to test in every way. We know that happens. Or, you know, even be worry-free. A worry-free life is not promised. However, if we trust in God, He will prove to be everything we need to remain faithful to Him through whatever comes our way. Focusing on the good news, the salvation through Christ Jesus, the promises of God, and our hope in these things helps us to direct our energy and our life course to the positive, peaceful, hopeful, truly more important things, and protects us from unnecessary fears and anxieties and being overly worried, and from dangers and snares, traps, pits, getting lost in predatory attacks and entanglements. Living a life of godly fear, keeping His commandments, and staying on the narrow path of life and not being distracted or allowing ourselves to be detoured provides all this protection and much, much more. May we be living in a manner where we are afforded every aspect of God's protection. Thank you so much for joining me and for your valuable time. I appreciate you very, very much. Please join us again next week for the next topic brought to you in spirit and in truth. Until then, go with God. Signing off for now with much love, Agape and Philia. But if we are the body, why on earth?